Hi everyone. In this video, I will teach you how to convert this mesh into real hair. The hair here is divided into three parts according to density. Select this mesh. Turn on this button to display so you can see what I did. Double-click to select the vertical loop line closer to the middle position, press Shift, and select the rest. Repeat this, so I speed it up a little here. There are more loop lines for braids, because there are some interspersibility. After selection, Control L invert the selection and delete the edge. These are the parts we need. Convert these edges into curves. Here, object convert curve so that all these edges become curves. Adjust the position of the first of the curve here. Select all, and then deselect the first, which means that the point that is not selected is the first of the curve. So what we have to do now is to unify the first direction of these curves. We don't need to pay attention to the braids, because we can't see both ends of it. Select these first directions that are inconsistent with other curves. Control L selects the connecting part, and here the segment. Switch direction, okay, the direction is converted, which means that the first and end directions of the selected curves have been reversed. Okay, now the first direction has become consistent and return to object mode. We will use this free plugin called Hair Mesh, and I will put its download link into the video description. You can download it. Click on the edges to hair, and then click Add Hair Modifier. Then adjust the number of hairs generated by each curve, as well as hair radius, noise, and other parameters. You can slowly adjust the parameters until you're satisfied with. Here I chose to separate the braids separately because they are different in radius. So I regenerated this modifier. Enable clump so that we can control the radius of the hair first through clump min and clump max. Adjust this hair radius to make it more appropriate. Continue to adjust these parameters and you can slowly until you feel satisfied. Try it in render mode. It doesn't look good because the hair radius is too small, so turn it up a little. It looks much better now. Then we do the same thing for the braid. Add a material to the hair. Select the principled hair BSDF and assign a color to the hair. It's a bit slow. I'm I'm going to switch to EV to take a look. You can still observe better results in cycles, but I don't recommend that because it will be very slow and you can use cycles when rendering. Okay, the operations performed on the rest hair are the same as before, so I will speed up here. If you want to select loop lines in all vertical directions of a mesh, just select a loop line on a mesh, and then to select loops edge rings. This is the final effect. By the way, I suggest switching to cycles will be better when rendering the last time. Just like this effect. Okay, if you think this video is helpful to you, please subscribe my channel and like. It will be a great help to me. Thank you a lot, guys. See you next time.